St. Paul is really Barnabas is considered to be the closest to being an apostle. We first read about him in Acts of the Apostles. He was apparently a leader already. And after the resurrection and after Pentecost, as the Christian community was kind of coming together in Jerusalem, he sold some of his property and laid the donations, you know, the proceeds from it, at the feet of the apostles. So his first act was an act of selflessness and generosity, giving his property over to the early church so that it could assist the poor and assist the needs of this young faith community. Later, because he was apparently known for his strong faith in the risen Christ, he was sent to Antioch. Antioch was the third most important city in the whole Roman Empire. It was an enormous population there, kind of held down the eastern part of the empire. He was sent to Antioch, and when he got there, he apparently found a large number of people of faith, Christians, who were zealous in living the faith. He was so taken by that, then he went to visit St. Paul, whose conversion he had heard about, and he brought Paul from Tarsus back to go with him to this area where they both ministered together. And later, he introduced St. Paul to the big apostles in Jerusalem, and they commissioned Barnabas and Paul to go on their first missionary journey together. During the midst of their journeys, Paul and Barnabas became embroiled in this issue about whether or not Gentile converts to the faith should undergo circumcision. So they went to Jerusalem together to meet with the other apostles. And it was Barnabas and Paul who spoke on behalf of the Gentiles by encouraging the other apostles not to require circumcision for Gentiles. And their position is what held over. It's believed that after the death of St. Paul, Barnabas eventually traveled to Syria, where he was martyred. According to some ancient sources, it's believed that Barnabas wrote the letter to the Hebrews, which really doesn't have an author that we know of, and the non-biblical writing called the Epistle of St. Barnabas. But these might simply be they're speculative about whether or not any of the writings we have were from his hand. Today, Barnabas is considered to be the patron saint of Cyprus, where his relics are kept. In today's first reading from the Acts of the Apostles, we're told that Barnabas was, quote, a good man, filled with the Holy Spirit and faith. Even though we may not know very much about Barnabas, isn't it enough that the scriptures describe him as a good man, filled with the Holy Spirit and faith? Wouldn't it be wonderful if we were described in the same way by those who came after us? If anyone remembers anything about us after we're gone, shouldn't they remember that we were good people filled with the Holy Spirit and faith? It is true, we may not be as charismatic as St. Paul or St. Barnabas or any of the early Christians. We may not go to distant lands to proclaim Christ. We may not become martyrs or saints. We may never leave any spiritual writings behind, as many of the saints did. But in the end, it is enough to be known as a good person, filled with the Holy Spirit and faith. That's the goal that we can have for ourselves. We are good people when we use the Holy Spirit within us